Hello, everybody. My name is Invicta. Welcome back to RimWorld. Thank you, everybody, for the support on the RimWorld series. I'm glad that everyone has been enjoying it. I've been enjoying playing it, and I'm glad that everyone is sort of paying attention to the storylines. I mean, it's hard to keep with it. I understand that, but it's fun nonetheless. So we last left off here. Jenna and Maggie went toe-to-toe and just got buck wild. Jenna almost killed Maggie with her bare fists. And that required her to get knocked out, but not before Maggie went Superwoman on Jenna and bit her, drawing quite a bit of blood on her right leg. So these two girls just went toe-to-toe, and it was scary. Now, something I want to mention really quickly, because somebody asked, how is it possible that Maggie got hit so badly? Like, she got hit so hard? Well, you got to remember that Jenna is high on go juice, and she has a go juice addiction, which is basically... think of it sort of like caffeine, but like a supercharged Red Bull. It's basically crack, but in a soda form. So that's why Jenna was able to just hit her like a billion times in half a second. The goals for today here. We have our growing zones. People were saying that I should centralize the heater next to or inside of the growing zones. And to be quite honest, I never even really thought about that. But I mean, if it makes a difference, sure. I've always just put it off in the corner just because I thought it was just easier, but yeah. Actually, that's gonna... Whoa, no. We're not trying to build stuff. No. We ain't building stuff here. We're just trying to reinstall it. There we go. Reinstall it. I don't need to be building a bunch of extra heaters. But yeah, to be quite honest, I never thought about doing that just because I didn't think it made a difference, but apparently it does. So we want to get steel out of the way. We want to make sure that we have some way of smelting. I believe that we just got done doing smithing, didn't we? Or is it machining? I think machining is smelting. No? See, now you got me confused now. Brain. Thanks for confusing myself, brain. Give me a second here. Yeah, we already have the smithy. Cool. Yeah, so I want to get the smithy up and running because we have a lot, and I mean a lot of steel slag that we can melt down. And that's going to give us a pretty healthy supply of steel. Now, I am going to move where we're keeping our wood. The wood only. I'm going to move that somewhere else because this is where I need to set up the electric smithy. Because I want there to be a just like, you know, stop and go. I want it to be easily accessible from within the same part of the warehouse. Now, it's also getting kind of cold here. And we need to be building our... Well, we... basically need to be building our heaters. So there's a lot of stuff to do. We've got a lot of different things that we need to do today. All right, heaters are up. Everyone's roasty toasty except for Jenna. These do not have power for some reason, team. Because there's no power conduit over there that's able to access them. All right. When you say access, you got to say excess. It makes you sound fancy. It makes you sound smart. So yeah, we are waking up Jenna, but that's alright. She'll be alright. She's knocked out anyway. Baynard trying to recruit Knight. Lowered the resistance a little bit. Good job. Now, oh yeah, something else people were telling me. People were saying that if you, and again, this is not something I've been able to confirm yet, because I never even thought about doing this, but somebody mentioned the other day that if you strip their clothes off before they die, the clothes actually do not become tainted. And honestly, that's a really good idea. I never would have even dreamed of that. So I'm going to try that next time we get raided. Hopefully we don't get raided today, because we do have a lot of stuff we need to do. Coach Krendor, going to be cleaning up stuff. Since we don't have a research bench going active right now. How much steel do we actually have? We've got 54 steel, which is not enough. Who is this? Oh, yeah, it was Kimmy. Oh, no, the doctor. Wow, there's a lot of muffalo there. It's September. Let's go ahead and get some more steel here because I want to get the smithy up. We need to get more winter clothes made. So Force Strategy Gaming needs to get on that. Are these bills done? Cold snap. Fantastic. What a great time for us to have a cold snap, right? As I was talking about there being a need for, you know, winter clothes. How many parkas we have? We have four parkas. That should be enough, actually. We need toques. We need toques. And t-shirts can come out after the toques. Okay, so a cold snap. Basically, what the cold snap is it's a very deep, hard freeze. So you need to make sure that you have a fire source, you have a heat source in basically every single room where your colonists dwell. If you don't, they're going to be in trouble because they can die. People can die of hypothermia. I've never seen people actually die of hypothermia, but it is possible. Yeah, so Civicta needs to. We need to get this corner done. There we go. That should give us hopefully power. There we go. And this is really where it's important to have the heat. Smoke leaf is ready to harvest. Hey, we got rice and smoke leaf ready to go to harvest. Oh, it's because it's Maggie. All right, Husky, you need to take over for that then. Where's Husky at? Yeah, Husky needs to harvest our he's harvesting our cash crop here. Smoke leaf, even though we haven't done anything with it yet. So as you see here, it's 14 degrees outside. And for those of you on the metric system, it's something outside. Yeah, Coach, it's 12 degrees outside right now. It's really cold. 340 steel, it's good. Good, good, good. Where am I going to put the wood, though? That's right. Came out exactly how I wanted it to. Let's store the wood over here with the stone chunks as well. Because this is where we're going to end up putting the... putting the stone cutters storage here. So I'm going to go ahead and delete this zone because we're not going to need it anymore. Let's make a door. Door right there. Right there. And right there. Just to keep it lined up. It's -1 degree Fahrenheit outside, team. You may not want to. It's actually dangerous to be outside right now. Ooh, it's 25 in the dungeon. Let's get Nida heater. I don't want to torture the poor girl. Forrest, what are you doing? Building a wooden wall? No. I want you to build this heater. We don't want Night freezing to death. She's no good to anyone dead. Oh man, it's a cold snap and a hard snow. It's about to get really, really, really cold. Warm clothes. Baynard needs warm clothes. Baynard, dude, we've got parkas here. -29 degrees in the kitchen as well. That heater already broke, Force! What the heck? That was a brand new heater, Force, and you already broke it? Alright, Raphael is fine. Roast beef is fine. Where's Pork Chop? Pork Chop, she's somewhere. Oh, that's sweet, sweet steel. Only 466 units of steel, which is not a whole lot. But that should be good enough to get us going here and get the smelter going. This has to get aired in. Area been revealed. So what happened there is that whenever there's like a hollow portion, if you're mining somewhere, or if you go into a building that you previously did not own, it will become revealed after you go inside of there. So it's five degrees in here. It's nice and 70 degrees in there. The kitchen's starting to warm up a little bit. It's really cold inside the living area. You see here that the growing areas, though, are staying nice and warm at 70 degrees. So even though it's the worst possible combination of weather and temperature outside, it's still we still have a nice, healthy growing season. And that's the part that's important. That's the reason why you want to get these indoor growing facilities pronto. I can't believe Maggie is still out right now. Okay, Crendor needs something to do. So let's get machining going. There you go, Coach. many components do we have? We have 33 components. I don't know. I didn't. Where did we get all that stuff from? Okay, so I'm gonna delete the wood. And let's make a zone over here. This is gonna be a stockpile zone for wood. So we can stick the wood right there. Wood. All right, we're gonna clear everything, but we're gonna keep wood right there. Now, we're gonna make our stone cutting benches in here as well. So we want to have a place where we can store all of our stone chunks. And I think the best place for that is going to be over here on this side. But we don't want to block. We basically don't want to block the walkways here because it does slow people down. So we're gonna say that this is going to be stone chunks. We could probably put, what is this, marble? Let's say marble. Marble. So we only want marble and marble bricks over here. Which are not textiles. Where is it? Stone blocks. Marble. As preferred. Okay, and then we're going to make another stockpile zone here. It's three across, three across. I'm going to actually leave a spot that is open for a walkway here. And this can be slate. So this will be slate. Clear all, and then we're going to do the same thing that we just did. We're going to say we only want to have slate chunks and slate blocks there. Okay. And that's going to be the wood. So we need to get all this stuff. All this stuff needs to be hauled out of here. So that's slate. This is marble. All that stuff. So yeah. So we want all this to be hauled. So all of our haulers will come in and reorganize this, as you see right here. Now, let's go ahead and get the smithy up and running over here. Oh, I'm just going to play. Don't mind me, guys. I'm just going to play horseshoes inside of, like, you know, our metal. That's pretty metal. All right, bad temperature. I don't know why that's a work penalty, but sure. We'll build another heater over here. So it's nice and toasty. We'll also get ourselves a chair. Yeah. There we go. Oh, not the smithy. It's the, what am I thinking? Not the smithy. It's the smelter. Electric smelter, yeah. I'll remove this real quick here. Make sure it's oriented correctly. There we go. And we want to make sure that we can keep steel here as well. We don't need to keep just slag only. So we're just going to name this steel. There we go. Eventually. Knight, how you doing? How's it holding up? Resistance remaining 13.7. She's coming around. Coming around. It might be minus 8 degrees Fahrenheit outside. I don't know what that turns into for Celsius, but I have a feeling it's probably like negative 40. It's pretty cold. Not gonna lie, it's pretty cold. But that's what's great about RimWorld, is that also the environment does indeed change. All the non-winter faring animals also kind of go away. We got a turkey to hunt, a rabbit to hunt. I do want to take down the buffalo, because we're gonna need their wool as well. Did that boom rat just eat something? I didn't know boom rats were carnivorous. Apparently they are. All right, Husky. Husky's hunting a rat. He did it. seem to have had a power outage. Coach Krender has experienced inspiration. He will move faster. What's wrong with Jenna? Jenna, what do you need? Jealous of Sinvicta's bedroom, Goju's withdrawal. Okay, so this is what happens whenever you have an addict. The problem with addicts... Oh yeah, by the way, notice the fire melts the snow, which is really neat. It's a nice little addition. So the problem with addicts is that they can actually get... They can get over their addiction. It just takes a long, long time. That Husky, that's screwed up. So it takes a long time, but addicts can indeed get over their addiction, and you just have all you got to do is just put if you can put up with it. If you basically just want, if you only want them to get over it and nothing else, you have to make sure that you restrict their drug use. So, and you can do that by going to this and say no social drugs at all, none, no drugs. Now, like I said earlier in another episode, you cannot do anything about the chemical interest trait or the chemical fascination trait. That's going to be automatic, so nothing you can really do about that. But hey, at least the cold snap's over. Curious. What the heck? Nothing, no one told me about Curious. What's going on here? What the heck, game? Get this Lynx out of here. Great shot by Husky. Tore off his right leg. He's going to die in 3 hours. Husky, you got to rescue him. We're not going to lose Curious. What the heck, man? I didn't see any alert for that. Baynard, who's our most skilled doctor? They need to be here now. Baynard. No, you need to tend to Curious. He's gonna die in 2 hours. Where'd this stupid cat come from? He gets the best quality medicine. You just gotta stop the bleeding right now. And someone get a fire going in here. A cougar is hunting pork chop for food. Great. Baynard apparently doesn't like force. No, we gotta kill the cougar. Where's that cougar? There it is. Pork chop. Animals. Pork chop. Get into the barn. Force. Protect pork chop. Jenna, what are you doing? Shoot that cat. Curious? He's still bleeding. Don't shoot Husky. Sinvicta, I know what's going to happen. Just don't do it. Get this cat out of here. Forrest, what are you doing? Fire. It's almost near disaster over here. All right, we got cougar meat now. Great. Great. Good job, team. My guess is that I probably had an alert over here. Husky, don't. I probably had an alert, I just didn't know it. Catatonic. Jenna has suffered a total mental breakdown and entered a catatonic state. He will recover in several days. What? I think that might be a little bit of a typo there. This happened because of poor mood. He will recover in several days. Oh my god. People who were worried about, oh, is RimWorld going to be too easy? He must be on the easiest setting in the world. No. When RimWorld wants to be like Darkest Dungeon, RimWorld's going to be like Darkest Dungeon. 76 quality, curious, how you doing? He's fine. He did lose a right front leg, though. So now our Husky's going to move, like, very, very slowly. And unfortunately, you cannot actually attach like a wooden leg or something to the dog like you can for humans. Oh my god, what a complete wreck. It's a fire. Don't worry about the fire. We got nothing to worry about for fire. Okay, the smithy's up, but it's not plugged in. The electric smith, or not smithy. I keep calling it smithy. The smelter. The smelter is installed, but we don't have power. Why are these not being worked on, team? Because the fire is distracting people. Look, see this? Don't worry about it. Fire is not our concern. It'll go out. It's cold outside. All right, we have our two new. There we go. Thank you, Force, for making it nice and warm in there for him. We need kibble too, actually. We need a lot of things. We need a lot of things done here. We got like half of the things that I wanted to do done today. But it's alright. Savicta is still working on night. Maggie came by just to insult her. Good job, Maggie. Resistance down to 11. Alright, so she's gonna be recruitable soon. Jenna's still in a catatonic state. Never mind the explosion, that was just a boom rat dying. Okay, so you might want to know, how do you make kibble? Kibble is made at the wooden butcher table, and we say, hey, let's make some food for our dear four-legged friend, or our dear four-legged and three-legged friend. So you can have your colonists. Now, sometimes I'll keep butcher creature on forever, and then leave the kibble on forever as well. It's not a really good idea because they do use actual like human edible food as well to make kibble. This is fine. You don't want to do that. You want to make sure that you limit the amount of kibble that you're making. Curious no longer capable of walking. Curious is back from the brink. He's in severe pain, but he's all right. It's a pretty warm winter outside. 64 degrees and it's winter. It's not bad. All right, melt steel slag, and we want to do this forever. Now again, I like to play it to where you can. It's modular for the workload that I have people do. Husky's idle. Husky, you have nothing to do. I guarantee you, I can find you something to do. Yeah. So we want to smelt from. I think it's crafting, right? Yeah. Husky's crafting. What are you at? A 3? It's not very good. 4 Strategy Gaming's at 8. We do have some toques. You know what, Husky? Do I really want Husky crafting? I put him at a, I guess he can try crafting if he's got nothing else to do. Let's see, the cargo pods. We got 5 components. Nice. Let's get those loaded up right now. So Victor's consuming a simple meal. Hauling, and haul that first. Even though Baynard was getting it, I don't care. You haul it. Curious is still resting. Coach, working on the research. I appreciate that, Coach. Maggie's idle. Maggie has nothing to do? Maggie, what is your cooking at? Maggie's at a 6. You can cook. Hey, you know what, Maggie? You've got nothing new to cook. I'll let you cook. Starvation, Jenna. Don't worry, Force has got you. Your brother's got you, Jenna. Yeah, there you go. Force is doing that. I think we're out of cloth, so we can't make any more. Yeah, we need to harvest that cotton. How's the cotton coming along? Still got a ways to go, but I mean, we've got enough stuff to handle us right now, to keep us going here anyway. Kibble does get consumed very quickly. Can we make packaged meals yet? I think we can, actually. We can. That's right. All right, let's do 30 packaged meals. Because we got to go. We actually haven't done anything as far as the caravan stuff is concerned yet. And we have some stuff that, I mean, we don't care about the prisoner quest. What about this one? This is the item stash. Tech prof sub persona core pain stop. We don't care about that. I think the other quests actually may have disappeared. But yeah, I don't care about the prisoners. Like we don't need more people right now. What we need to do is we need to get our walls up, we need to get our kill box up, we need to get turrets going as well. That's something that I should have researched first, actually, was getting turrets done. But it's alright. We had to line up our priorities here. Baynard making the kibble. I think that it's good enough to make a second stove now, so let's go ahead and make that. And once we get the cotton going and get the cloth going, I'll hold that thought. A group of pirates from Baffin's Howitzers have arrived nearby. They will prepare a while and then attack. Okay, so they've got 2 melee and 2 auto machine pistols. Oof. Okay, team. I'll let everyone go about their day, but we need Pete. No. Force and Maggie, you're going to be needed. I wish we had Jenna for this too. Okay, the stove is ready. I'm just gonna make our preparations real fast. Say 11. Good enough. Husky smelting stuff, thank you, but we need to get everyone up and rocking. I hate to do that to the night owls, I really do. But we got stuff. Now where would be a good place for us to hold up? I guess I'm probably right around here. At least there's some structure. The night owls are going to be real grumpy, but hey, you know what? You got to do what you got to do. You got to protect your own. Yeah, let's station the corners here. So we need our riflers to be in place there. And then our pistoliers. We can jump them from, we can flank them over here. Same with Force. Maggie, where are you? Oh, she's already up there. Whoa! Jumping the gun. Haha, joke's on you. We even got, look at that, we got a freebie. Sucks, don't it? So this guy was wandering and actually was not, we caught him off guard. So that's one down already. That's a great job, team. That's a big time play right there, team. Big time play. That's what we talk about. All right, here comes the assault. So the flank's working beautifully. This guy's coming in. Who's he going after? He's going after, it looks like, Baynard. So Baynard. Oh, they're fleeing. No prisoners. No prisoners here at Mosh Pittsburgh. Take him out, for. Actually, Force, you and Maggie go to sleep. Baynard. Oh, it's a poor machine pistol. Baynard, Oh, man. That guy is fast, man. Look how fast that guy is. Baynard, no, don't. Dude, just let him go, man. We can't catch up to him. Good lord. We actually shot that guy, too. We actually got the kill over here. Great job, team. Let's get these weapons and stuff. Yeah, so if one of them had survived, I was going to strip them before their clothes got tainted, but yeah, I'm not worried about moving. Ooh, we got antelope here, or gazelle. The gazelles are fantastic cuz they don't attack and they also have a ton of meat. So yeah, so that was actually a really good thwarting there that we did. Good job, team. I'm proud of you. That's a good positive note to end it on. So, but anyway, thank you for watching, everyone. I really do appreciate the continued support on RimWorld, and it's been doing very well. I'm glad that the game is exciting a lot of people. I'm also glad that people have been picking up the game. You can check it out over on Steam. And actually, if you find a Humble Bundle, I do have a Humble Bundle referral partner link as well, which I'll be leaving down in the description below if you want to help out and support my channel. In other ways, you can find RimWorld on the Humble Bundle. I think it's on there, but I'll double check that. If it's not, then I won't put the link. If it is, I'll put the link up. Hey, Jenna's back, but she's no longer capable of walking, and she's got an extreme brake wrist. She'll be all right. She'll be all right. So anyway, thank you for watching, everyone. Hope you had a great start to your midweek. And as always, I'll see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody!